Good day to everyone, my name is Zenrup Gamad, and today I'm here to present to you the graphical debugging tool of the Scheme IDE named Dr. Racket. In order to demonstrate the application of the built-in debugging tool and appreciate how powerful it is when it comes to correcting errors and unexpected behaviors of a Scheme program, I came up with a program that calculates the parking fee of a customer from utilizing a particular parking space. I modified the program in a way that would result in an error, and my objective is to fix it by locating where is the cause of that error by using the debugging tool of Dr. Racket. Let us now run the program and enter appropriate input for the sake of this demonstration. Let's just rise this up. Now the program opens up with identifying the type of vehicle that the customer uses. For the sake of this demonstration, let's just say the customer had a car. The customer entered at 6 o'clock a.m. or 0600 in military standard hours. And he left the parking area at 1800 or 6 o'clock p.m. in military standard hours. The first error will come up where it will pop up the total parking fee, even though it has not yet taken into consideration if the customer took an overnight rate. After saying no, that will be the only time where the program will output the total amount of the parking fee that the customer must have to pay. As you can see, it resulted in a void return of value. To fix this, I will now use the debug button, which is located on the upper right hand corner of the graph of Dr. Racket. Click on the debug, and the application will set up into a debug mode where two additional panels will display, the stack and variables panel that will display the current methods and the local variables being utilized in the execution. After I have established what are the errors of my code to place, the next part for me is to identify which part of the code is responsible for that particular error. Now, I'm going to click here in this part because this is where the part where the calculation of the parking fee took place. As you can see, whenever you put your cursor on the very beginning of the line, it will appear a circular red dot that signifies where the breaking point will take place. Just right click on this and there will be two options, either pause or continue to this point. I'm gonna click pause. That means that I already established that this is the breaking point where the debug will start. Now, the next step for me is to run the program. Same as always, I'm gonna input the same value that I input before. Car 0600 1800. And now the program will now pause and will go into the breaking point. After going into the breaking point, you can now use the step button to identify where we did go wrong. It jumped to the breaking hours. We see 600 and 800. Now, I saw that my program computed a negative value, which is not the case because there are no negative time. So in order for me to fix this is I need to change the X and Y value, because the X corresponds to the time that I entered and the Y corresponds to the time that I left. So let me just change this to Y and X. And now I'm gonna change this value to less than enter and greater than leave. Now let after that I'm gonna close the debug button and run again the program. Car 0600 1800. No. And now the program outputted the total correct fee, that the amount that the customer must pay for the particular parking area. That is how you use the debugging tool of the Dr. Racket, and I hope you learned something from it. Thank you very much for listening, and may you have a wonderful time ahead.